station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Kayla LaFrance. This week was a busy one aboard the orbiting laboratory as the crew prepared the station for new and continued science. NASA astronaut Chris Cassidy spent part of his week setting up the Advanced Plant Habitat facility for the next round of growth operations. That facility provides an enclosed environment to support plant and bioscience research. Logistics is a large part of keeping science experiments running on board the space station. An experiment such as the Advanced Plant Habitat require use of consumable station resources, such as water and power, in order to operate successfully. This week, three of the large payload racks, known as the Express Racks, were moved to new locations that better accommodated their size and resource needs. We just assigned another NASA astronaut to an upcoming commercial crew mission, with more flights right around the corner. NASA's Jeanette Epps was assigned to the Starliner 1 mission, the first operational flight of Boeing's CST-100 Starliner. She'll join veteran NASA astronaut Sonny Williams and fellow first-time flyer Josh Quesada on a six-month expedition scheduled for the later part of 2021. Prior to that, Boeing is gearing up for its uncrewed orbital flight test 2, no earlier than this December, followed by the first crew flight on Starliner, targeted for next June. Question: have you been following NASA astronaut Chris Cassidy on Twitter? You really should. The ISS commander has been busy on his social media account, @astro_seal, sending down breathtaking images and heartfelt messages of various events happening on our planet from his vantage point in orbit. The power of hurricanes Laura and Genevieve, the devastation of fires in California and the Amazon, and the tragic explosion in Beirut are some of his recent postings on Twitter. Chris also captures Earth's awe and beauty with amazing views of our planet. You can follow his journey on both Twitter and Instagram. Keep sending in your questions using the #AskNASA. We'll see you next time.